through these movements. And as I was walking through these movements, that these movements already established in my head, I would also instruct my camera operator and say, this is the shot I want. I want this shot, that shot, and then, you know, this is the long shot, and I would cut away from this shot, and basically just drawing out all the visions on from my head and working with all my technicians, cameraman, my martial art assistants, and everyone on the set, you know, my actors, the props, and then we would walk through it several times, and we go right into it. We didn't have enough. We usually don't have enough time anyway, right? But in SPL case, we didn't have that many so-called rehearsal times to block it out. So we pretty much went to the set and start shooting it. I wanted to bring all the back to the basic martial art fighting, which is something that I think audience haven't seen for many, many years. Too many action films, whether they're big production Hollywood films or even Hong Kong local smaller budget action films, they get carried away with the sophistication of filmmaking nowadays, moving the camera, editing, and CGI or whatever, right? And they've forgotten that the higher degree of martial art filmmaking is the performer itself, the martial art actor himself, how he deliver his movements. So in that long sequences in that alley scenes, I purposely wanted to capture the one take, as many movement as possible. The shot as wide as possible, because sometimes a lot of people tend to use a lot of close-ups. Actually, close-up is easier because you don't see the legs and you don't see the body language, and so therefore it takes a lot less out of the performance. But to really perform in a wide shot, the artist has to really put out to make it right. You can't slow it down, you can't be lazy, you gotta get down to the stances, and you gotta. So that scene, it was purposely planned out, and I wanted to capture a long shot, and basically I told Wu Jing, you know, and I understand that he have years of experience of Chinese wushu, meaning these form demonstration. So he's very good at the body language and big movements. So I said to him, I said, you know, this is something that I want to capture, you know, like more of a freestyle realistic fighting. And I gave him a guideline, a directions, like, okay, I'm going to come at you, like say 20 to 30 moves and in control, of course, but basically I want to do this and do this. And I want you to do something in return and attack me. In the beginning, he was a little bit nervous about the whole idea, because then he said to me, that's almost like real fighting. And I told him, don't worry about it, because I have my own experience of combat and different. Ever since I was young, I was more into the sparring experience. So I told him, this is the kind of concept I wanted to bring. This is kind of flavor, almost like real fighting. So in the beginning, he was a little bit, wasn't too sure about the idea. I said, you know, let's try it out. Don't worry. But of course, in my mind, once I roll the camera, I'm gonna push it to the limit. Basically, I wanted to get him going and push him where he really react, instead of reacting to the moving to the choreography. Actually, there weren't a choreography for those couple of shots. It was a directions. It was a guideline of positioning. All the movements were free, basically like a free sparring. But when I rolled the camera, I pushed the envelope. I really really attack him. But of course, I pulled back and just to feel, you know how sometimes when you see two boxers when they play low and they first start off and just jabbing, playing off, and then they would push the envelope a little bit and they would eventually end up a real sparring section. That's what I wanted in that particular few shots in that scene, is to get my opponent really react to real reaction. And then what does he do? He wanted to really attack me. Then I just kind of work along with it, you know, and then to capture it. That's one thing I wanted to capture, and successfully it worked. You know, it came out really looking real because it was almost real, you know. And the other thing I wanted to do was to really fight with impossible, really hard to shoot, is short weapons. He was using a knife and I was using a baton, police stick. Now, usually when people start shooting these kind of shorter range, smaller objects, they use a lot of close-ups, which is understandable because so the audience can see the character of the objects and to enhance the power of that objects or the weapons. But like I said, in this scenes, I wanted to show the how real they are. So I didn't really go right to the close-up of these weapons, which made it very difficult, because very difficult to swing around with a little knife in a wide shot. Because first of all, you can't see the knife because the shot is so wide. So what do? You really have to move your body and really perform with your body and then really make these weapons as threatening as possible using these big movements. That's also, I don't think many people dare to attempt to do, you know, to put on a screen like that and shoot short objects and short weapons in such a wide shot, because you can easily at the end looking with no power at all, no effects, you know, no threat, not threatening at all. But you know, everything worked out, you know. So I was very pleased with those couple of shots. You really put it on the screen and it take a lot, not only the concept, but you also take two performers really understanding how to move with their body in a wide shot, big movement. At the same time, really know how to control themselves. Otherwise, I mean, we could have killed each other, but you know, it worked out, you know, and I knew what I was doing. To shoot something like that, it has to be as real as possible. And to capture realism, you can't repeat it all the time. You know, after a while, it will become mechanical. It will become repetition, right? So I think the best reaction should be the first time. But of course, we have to make some adjustment of maybe, you know, the cameraman couldn't maybe out of frame. So we made a few adjustments. It took us about 2 or 3 times. Yeah. When I'm directing myself, obviously it's much harder than when I'm directing another person. But on the other hand, sometimes it's easier because I know exactly what I want out of that shot and I'll deliver. Whereas if I'm just action directing for another, even if he's the greatest martial artist, but he doesn't understand what kind of vision, what kind of body language that I want on that shot. So he can't give me the exact flavor what I'm talking about. I'm not even talking about movements, because movements are just movement, like Bruce Lee said. We can all throw a sidekick, but to throw a sidekick with charisma, uniqueness, that's something special. That's something that takes a lot of years of film experience, acting experience, understanding your lens and your interacting with the audience. You're flirting, you're playing with the audience, right? That takes a lot. So when I'm directing myself, on one hand, physically, mentally, I'm harder, much harder on me because I have to do it all, right? But on the other hand, it's easier because I pretty much know, okay, I need this shot and how many movements and the way I move, I'm gonna work. I'm gonna synchronize with the camera. You know, these camera movements is something that I already planned out. So at the end, it's very specific. As a actor in front, working in front of a camera, because after just so many years of working in these type of films, and those films were the standard of those films were so, the level was so high that it gave me so much experience, so much knowledge of. Right now, you can just turn the camera and I have a sixth sense. I have I have a feeling of, even if the camera's behind me, and I know that in which angle I'm being shot. And sometimes I make adjustment for the cameraman. So if his timing is a little off, or for example, if his camera comes too close, I would adjust my choreography and physical movements, and by taking a step back and to keep in that specific framework, specific rhythm and physical expression on these shots. So I kind of work hand to hand. It's like dancing with the cameraman. Why do I think it took that journey to have SPO discovered, just like any other great film? I think filmmaking today is a collaboration of not only talents and technicians and salesperson. It takes a lot of timing and it has to go through its own journey, right? Being tested, you know, and test the water, and you just never know. I mean, the biggest box office, I understand that many successful American Hollywood blockbuster, they were put in shelf for the longest time until they were, one producer came up with a vision and thought that, let's do this, and boom, you have box office groundbreaking numbers, you know. I think that's what happened to SPL, you know. I think there's an old Chinese saying, you know, if you real goal, you know, you can withstand the test through time. What do I think this film worked? I think first of all is obviously the action. It's how these action were shot. I mean, yes, some of the choreography they were interesting and they were refreshing, at least for the longest time audience haven't seen these type of movements, and then having some wider shots and long shots, seeing two real martial art actors without cutting away, showing off their skills, and at the end fighting with Sammo, putting in some of the UFC fighting style. You know, that's something fresh, right? But I think it's the overall approach of how do you bring these action on screen on a cop movie. So, I mean, if you think of cop movies, cop gangster actions, you think of fast cutting. A lot of camera movements, right? In SPL case, we didn't really need that because we were so secure and so confident of the movement itself. The reason why I wanted to work with Wilson before SPL, because I wanted to really explore the possibility of these type of films. But usually when you think of, a martial art film or an action film, you don't think of heavy dramatic moments, right? You don't think of sensitive moments. Usually are just, fast-paced action, boom, you know, excitement. So combining a director like Wilson, I think it would be a great chemistry combining together, you know, having that type of artistic, slower pace, kind of more of a European style of filmmaking, you know, combining a Hong Kong action, Hollywood style actions, you know, combining the two would give you something fresh. And it worked in SPL.